Anything?
Mike.
So my experience was very good. I have 7 months of experience.
Okay. Oh, very good, fantastic. Good round of applause for that. Alright, so, you know, we were just having lunch together, we were just having a quick chat, trying to understand how businesses are, how industries are. One thing is very common that, you know, industries, you know, all these industries and businesses are changing far too quickly. You all can see that, right? Kisne socha tha, 5 saal pehle ki yaar, hum log baat karenge ki hum log electric gaadi chalayenge. Kona has just been launched, Hyundai, you know that, right?
Yes.
All of you?
Yes.
And there's a new brand of electric, you know, two-wheelers, Revolt. Have you heard about that brand?
Yes.
Yeah. 5 years back, nobody knew. Nobody could imagine that, you know, the future is going to be of electric cars, electric bikes, and that's going to happen so fast. We as a Japanese company were anticipating probably next 10 years would be the time span of starting electric cars and electric vehicles. Last night, my wife, she also works in a Japanese company like Panasonic, and she came back from Singapore, and she said that, you know, I can tell you one thing, Singapore is a country, it's a small country, very small country, probably 1/4 the population of Delhi, Delhi being the second most populated country, you know, city of the world now after Tokyo. She said that in next 5 years, air taxi is going to be a reality over there. That's how quickly things are moving. None of us know what we want to do in life. I here standing in front of you guys, I have no clue about what I'm going to do when I was your age. So is companies and businesses, the likes of Amazon or Flipkart. I'm sure many of you know that how Amazon started off. The founders were themselves delivering books, just like Flipkart too. Remember that, right? And that's when they gained a lot of knowledge, because any startup or any big company today that you can look for, maybe Oracle stays, Oyo, or you know, Flipkart, to Amazon, to Tesla, all these companies, the foundation of these companies are just one core line of business, and they're attached to it. Then they figure it out. There's a famous saying by Bruce Lee, there's a book written by Bruce Lee, he says that be like water, pure and shapeless. This is the next 5 years of your life, you have to be like water, pure and shapeless. Why? Because you need to absorb a lot of stuff in the next 5 years of your life, 2 years of your education now, and initial 3 years of your work life. One of which, the most important fact, time period is going to be your, again, your internship period. And how do you really identify careers? It's very easy, you know, whatever is your interest area is what your career is going to be. I mean, somebody's interest in life is into music, they would want to pick up music. Somebody's interest is into games, they would pick up some of the other sports. It all depends on how much of energy and time you are putting into it. Next 10 years is all going to be about project management and analytics. You, the future managers, now need to really focus your energies on two industries and what are the emerging industries that are going to come. Today, India luckily is a country wherein there is a huge gap between the infrastructure and the availability of infrastructure. When these gaps are there, that's where various opportunities lies. Likes of Voyos, likes of Flooper, or you know, there are many startups which are coming up now. Because that these startups are basically doing nothing, they are identifying the problem and providing some sort of a solution to it. We at Panasonic also identified one of the biggest problems that healthcare has. And why healthcare? Because one of the biggest industry. I specifically, for a personal reason, you know, picked up my career path to be healthcare. Reason being that, you know, 67% of the population today of India is millennials, people of my age, people born after 1980. And after 30 years, all of us are going to be old, right? That's very, very count between all of us. We're not getting younger. And when we go old, we have problems, health problems. Because the food we eat, the air we, you know, we breathe, and the water we're drinking today is all adulterated. So which is why I at a personal level identified, okay, fine, Siddharth, you need to choose an industry. The initial 5 years of your careers, you have no clue what you want to do in life. There was a slow and a very steady movement of my own career towards the healthcare sector. That's where I shifted to that line of business. I started and founded a company in alliance with a lot of other founders along with me. And we were able to successfully sell it off to one of the private equity firm. And that's when I realized that I want to really move into the core of the entire healthcare sector, because today I realize that the healthcare ecosystem delivery is not very, very sound. So I, at a personal level, started to do some work around there, some certification, some sort of a education qualification towards it. Why it is important that I want to leave this, this podium after giving you some sort of insights on what you want have to do in life. Very quickly, a student of B school would benefit the most if theoretical knowledge imparted is driven home through practical example. And how is that possible? Your internship. The best case scenario is when a B school student has some work experience, like maybe few of you studying over there, and a mix of students from diverse professional background and corporate culture. I'm sure many of you are BCom or a BBA or an engineering student previously. So a mix of knowledge that you have to share with each other. That's very important. They may not always be possible, as many B school students haven't been exposed to a corporate life. Like most of you have not been exposed to a corporate life, it's very important that once you get an opportunity, you make the most out of it. And once you make the most out of it and you have joined a company, you need to identify where you want to take your career towards to. What are the kind of things and changes that you need to bring into your life? What are the important changes? One is being aware of things. There are three A's of life, which is very important. One is acumen, allocation, action. Acumen, allocation, and action. Because you need to be a strategic resource to any way that you go in life in the future. Acumen. How do you build up acumen? There are small things that you have to do to build up acumen. It starts with a simple thing like reading newspaper every day. I would please, request you all to start and inculcate this habit of reading the newspaper. I know it's very boring. I will not take the 6th minute. I had promised that. So you need to start inculcating the habit of reading the newspaper. Harvard Business Review, 3 in a month are absolutely free of cost. You need to subscribe to